Hey. Another beautiful cinema evening, day. We ended up watching 3 movies. The first one was... I can't remember the title, damn it. Onward? The animation video? About a magic world and 2 brothers with a magic staff. It was different than the trailer originally had me thinking. Fun, but nothing too spectacular. After some lunch, we watched Gentlemen and Guns Akimbo. Let me talk about Guns Akimbo first. That's the Harry Potter with guns movie. So Daniel Radcliffe with guns stacked to his hands. Well wearing, I don't know, whatever dress it is. Shower thingy. And yeah, it is what the trailer lets you think it is. Nothing too... difficult storyline based. It has one plot twist that you don't really see coming, but it didn't really add anything to the story. And the major semi-plot twist is already spoiled in the trailer, but it's also spoiled in the movie. And then of course you have another smaller plot twist which is important for the storyline. But they also spoil it in the movie a little bit too early. So yeah, not that great. Some of the action is interesting. The choreography of the action is nice. But it has not the most amazing CGI. Talking about the action. There's one thing in the action that is messing up the movie a lot. She is a perfect shot. Like 8 out of 10. She shoots at him. Everything misses, like A-team style misses everything. They work together, you can see that in the trailer, no plot twist. And she hits everything again, 9 out of 10. How? And the same goes for Daniel Radcliffe, by the way. So, no, yeah, overall not that amazing. Some of the music is good, but even there, yeah, no. Humor, same thing, some of the jokes are good, and the rest, no, not really. So, yeah, maybe on Netflix or whatever, but I wouldn't really pay for it, if I'm honest. Unless you are a Daniel Radcliffe fan, then yeah, go for it. Gentlemen, however, Guy Ritchie film, so it is kind of a hate it or love it movie, but I love it. Not the best movie, but certainly good. Storyline is good. Here and there some plot twist, but probably the best selling point for me of that movie is the way how it's been told. So it starts interesting, and then we go back into time, and then we see this good, nice detective telling a story and bringing everything together, opening all the books and whatnot more, and that becomes really interesting to tell the story that way. It has been done before, of course, but like any good detective, he doesn't know everything, and that ends up troublesome for some characters in the movie. I need to fill them up. So really like the way it has been told. That's a plus point. Action is a plus point. The actors are a plus point. Even Matthew McConaughey and Charlie Hutman, I think. Oh man, I'm fucking up that name. The British guy that looks like like Tom Hardy. His acting is on point. Most of the acting is on point. The only down point is probably, I think it is a British rapper who has some scenes in a movie and does one of his songs. And I can see how it fits the movie, but could have done it otherwise, probably. I don't know, probably personal taste thingy, if you know what I mean. Maybe. Otherwise, great movie. Worth buying it? Yeah, probably. I can see it ending up on my DVD collection. Like most Guy Ritchie movies. And I know not everybody likes the Guy Ritchie movies. So far, I have liked all of them that I have seen. Who is Guy Ritchie again? Now, Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels, Snitch, Rick Rolls. He did, I think, The Last King Arthur, which I was also quite amazing. So I'm gonna end it here. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you have seen any of these movies and what your opinion about them is. And yeah, on to the next one. Week or three from now. This is my exit. Okay, thank you for watching.